Hey YouTube, it's iPhone Mastermind, and today I'm going to be doing an app review on an app called Burnout CRASH, and it's available for the iPhone, iPod Touch, and iPad. The main objective of this game is to wreck into an intersection and cause as much damage as possible. Each mode, however, is slightly different from the other, and there are a variety of intersections, so I'm just going to go ahead and choose this one and choose Rush Hour. Now here are a few objectives that you can try to get while you're playing, and the more stars you get, the more intersections and cars you unlock in the future. So the objective of Rush Hour is to cause the biggest crash possible in your 90 second time period. And so to control your car, you simply drag your finger the direction you want your car to go. And so now I'm going to go ahead and wreck into this intersection, and you simply control with your finger to swipe back and forth where you want to go after you have wrecked. So here you can see I'm just wrecking into a whole bunch of different cars, causing as much damage as possible. And I just got a power-up, which does differ between modes. And now I'm going to go ahead and show you this crash breaker bar in the bottom left corner. And as you can see, it is filling up. And once it's filled and is on fire, if you tap or swipe, the car will cause a small explosion, which will damage anything close to it and cause it to go outwards. So that's enough of this game mode, so I'm going to go ahead and exit out and move on to the next game mode, which will be Pile Up. As you can see with the objective screen, crash all the traffic, then burn them for big bucks. So I'm going to go ahead and steer the car into the intersection. And for now, I'm just wrecking vehicles as they go by. However, this bar in the top left corner and the counter with the 23 is the number of cars I need to get to reach my Inferno mode. And once I'm in Inferno mode, I simply need to keep causing things to explode or burn or crash down if it's a building, etc. for my combo to continue on. So basically, once my 16 counter in the top left corner reaches zero, I will be in Inferno mode and I will need to keep things burning and exploding, and traffic will cease at that point for my combo to continue. So now that my counter is complete, I'm in Inferno mode, and in this instance I'm not going to go very long just because I want to continue on with the review. But as you can see, the timer is ticking down and nothing's exploding, which is why the timer ran out. So this next and final mode is called Roadblock, and the objective is to stop the traffic escaping for as long as possible. So once again, I'm going to go ahead and just steer my car into the intersection to cause a wreck. And just like the other game modes, you can see there's a bar in the top left corner and a counter that currently says 46. Once that reaches zero, it will trigger a super feature, but currently you can see it's counting up to the current feature, which is the cop's car with the halo over it. So this game mode does feature a number of features as you continue on wrecking the vehicles. However, you cannot let any of them escape. You can see under the bar in the top left corner there are five X's, and you can see that car just escaped, which caused my bar to have one X, and there's a second one and a third one. And if I reach five, the game mode's over. However, if I have less than five but I still have some X's, the super feature will simply be decreased in power according to how many X's I have. This game is fun and destructive, however, it can get boring very easily, and if it's worth the $5 to you or not, that's simply your decision. I find myself playing it occasionally, however, for not very long. So once again, this game is called Burnout CRASH, available for the iPhone, iPod Touch, and iPad for $5 in the App Store. So thanks for watching this video. Please don't forget to like it up if you enjoyed it, and comment for any comments or questions you have about the game or video. And subscribe for more app reviews, Apple news, jailbreak news, tweak reviews, and more. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you all later.